Today we're going to be working on a jewelry box project using the new home decor stamps by Redesign with Prima. This design is called Elegant Scrolls. I start by removing my stamp from the package, and next I'm going to peel off the piece that I want to use for my project. I'm going to prepare my stamp just by using a sanding sponge to lightly scuff the top of the stamp. The light sanding just helps my stamp more readily accept the paint or ink that I'm going to put on it. My project includes a base of Dixie Belle paint from the Silk line, and the color is called Anchor, which is a nice, rich, deep black. I have two coats of Anchor on the body of this piece. The colors on my piece are gold and black, so I'm going to be using a gold metallic stamp pad just to fill the backside of my stamp. I do this just by patting the stamp pad around the backside of my stamp and making sure I have even coverage. Next, I'm going to place my stamp upside down and roughly align it where I want on the side of this drawer. Once I have my placement correct, I use my fingertips and lightly pad the top of the stamp to press it into my drawer side. Once I lift my stamp up, you can see that I have a beautiful impression of this gold image on the side of my drawer. I'm going to go ahead and refill my stamp with my ink so that I can go on and stamp my next drawer side, repeating the same process as I did on my first drawer. Once you flip your stamp upside down on your drawer side, you want to make sure that you don't move it about. Use your fingertips, but be sure that you're holding it in place at the same time. This will give you nice, clean stamp lines on your design. Stamps are meant to have a little bit of imperfection in their images. A little bit of smearing, a little bit of imperfect lines just adds to the aged look that stamps give. I prefer the clean, crisp look that inks give to the backside of my stamp, but you can also use these with your Dixie Belle paint. You would just take a little bit of your Dixie Belle paint onto a paper plate and then apply it with a crafting brayer to the backside of your stamp. A brayer is a small rolling pin type tool available from most craft stores, and it just rolls your Dixie Belle paint onto the stamp in a thin layer. Applying too much paint or ink to the backside of your stamp will cause it to smudge and smear, and you won't get clean, crisp lines in your image. I also chose to repeat my stamp process onto the lid of my jewelry box and then on the inside around the mirror. I added the gilded home and nature transfer to this piece from Redesign with Prima, and this gold stamp just ties in with the gold of the gilded home and nature transfer perfectly. Redesign with Prima inks also come in a variety of colors. They come on pads and then also in a liquid refillable ink. These stamps work great on a variety of projects because they're malleable. You can put these stamps onto curved or flat surfaces. Once I'm done with my stamping process, I take my stamps and I clean them using scrubby soap from Dixie Belle. I hope you've enjoyed this project using Redesign with Prima stamps over Dixie Belle paint from the Silk line. As always, you can find more Brush by Brandy on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, and YouTube.